So hello and welcome to another video from sickmaths.co.uk, where you can find lots of free maths videos. This one's about finding the highest common factor, or the HCF, the lowest common multiple, otherwise known as the LCM, and prime numbers. I'm going to begin with prime numbers because they actually help you work out the HCF and LCM, so you need to know a little bit about these first. So here are a couple of prime numbers, and what they all have in common is that they have no factors, except of course themselves and one, like any other number does. So here are two prime numbers I've stuck on one side, and each of them only have themselves and one as their factors. Okay, so that's that. And you'll notice, of course, 1 is not a prime number, even though it fulfills this requirement. And that's because prime numbers actually have a special job. Okay, and you'll see that in a minute. Basically, they are the building blocks of all numbers. So they're times together to make other bigger numbers. Now, if you have 1 as a prime number, and you times it by another prime number, it doesn't actually change anything. Timesing by 1 does nothing, so that's why 1 is not a prime number, because it is not really much of a building block for other numbers when you times it together to make another number. So that's that, really. So let's talk about finding the HCF and LCM in this example for 12, 18 and 24. Now, what does HCF stand for? Highest common factor. What does that mean? It just means the biggest factor that goes into all of these. So a factor of 12, 18 and 24 is 2, for example, but it's not the biggest factor. And what does LCM mean? Well, it's the lowest common multiple. That means the lowest multiple that is common to all of these. So what does that mean? Well, let's say just for 12 and 18 for now, a common multiple of that is 36. Okay, so a multiple of 12 is 36, and a multiple of 18 is also 36, and that's a common multiple. What we want to do is something even more complicated. We want the lowest multiple of all of these three numbers. So let's go and do that. So the first thing we need to do is break down our numbers. Our 12, 18 and 24 can be broken down like this, into multiples of prime numbers. So 12, let's say 24, let's take a big one. 24 can be broken down into, say, 12 times 2. I could have done 6 times 4, for example, but it doesn't really matter how you break them down, because you end up with the same prime factors at the end, which is what we're looking to get at the end of this. So 24 equals 12 times 2. 2 is a prime number, so it can't really be broken down into new factors, because prime numbers only break down into themselves and 1, as we said earlier on. So 24 equals 12 times 2. 2 can't be broken down, circle it. That's like a full stop. 12 can be broken down into 3 times 4. Again, as I said earlier on, I can pick any two numbers at times to make 12, because at the end you get the same factors. So 12 equals 3 times 4. 3 can't be broken down, circle it. 4 equals 2 times 2, and circle each of those because they're also prime numbers. So basically 24 equals 2 times 2 times 2 times 3, as I've written here. And that is actually writing 24 as a product of prime factors, a very important sentence, because that's what they ask for in the GCSE often. They say, give 24 or whatever as a product of its prime factors. So that means you have to use this factor tree, break it down, and do that, basically. And sometimes they ask for the product of powers of prime factors. So writing 24 as a product of its powers of prime factors would be writing it like this, because 2 times 2 times 2 is just 2 cubed. So it's just a short way of writing this thing. You write that instead. So anyway, so we've broken down our numbers, our 12, 18 and 24, into its prime factors, as you can see here. Actually, I've listed its product of powers of prime factors as well underneath. And then you stick those prime factors in rows like this, yeah? So 12's prime factors go here, 18's prime factors go there, and 24's prime factors go there. And what you do, as you might notice, is put them in nice columns of the same numbers. So I try to complete the column of 2's there, try to complete the column of 3's there. It's not always possible, because you might not have enough 2's, for example, in the 18 to complete the column of 2's there. That's quite obvious. And once I've done that, I can see that wherever there's a complete column of 2's, I put a 2 there, a complete column of 3's, I put a 3 there, and so wherever I've got complete columns, I put the number above it that belongs to that column. And so HCF is just the multiple of those two numbers times together, so 2 times 3 is 6. Okay, now HCF is a lot more simple. Wherever there is a number at all, forget if it's a complete column or not, I just times those numbers together. So there's a couple of 2's there, I put a 2 there. There's 2's there, I put a 2 there. 3's there, I put a 3 there. There's a single 3 there, still put a 3 there. A single 2 there, I put a 2 there. Right, so basically wherever there's a number, I put a number underneath it. And times those numbers together, 2 times 2 times 3 times 3 times 2 gives me 72, which is the LCM for 12, 18 and 24. And that's that. So just in case you don't have, say, 3 numbers, you know, you just have to have at least 2 numbers to find the HCF and LCM for them, because HCF stands for highest common factor, right? So you have to have something common between at least 2 numbers. You can't have common number between just 1 number itself, right? So say I forget this thing here, okay? So there's only 12 and 18 that I'm talking about. I want to find out the highest common factor for just 12 and 18, and the LCM for 12 and 18, okay? That means I've only got these two numbers, which means I don't have this row anymore, okay? And what else does it change? Well, I've got still two complete columns, a complete column of 2 and a complete column of 3, so that doesn't change. So the HCF is still 2 times 3, which is 6. Okay, but does anything change for the LCM? Well, that 2's gone, so that means that 2's gone. But otherwise, that 3 gave that 3, those 3's gave that 3, that 2 can give that 2 still, and those 2's give that 2. So the difference is that the LCM is now 2 times 2 times 3 times 3, which is now 36. Can I write that? 36. And that's it, really. That's how to find out the HCF and LCM of different numbers.